वेलकम बैक एवरीवन। आफ्टर लॉन्ग वैकेशन आई केम बैक अगेन बिकॉज ऑफ माय थीसिस पेपर एंड बिकॉज ऑफ माय सेमिस्टर इट वाज लेट। सॉरी नेट फर्स्ट आई वांट टू से सॉरी बिकॉज ऑफ लेट, बट फ्रॉम नाउ आई विल कंटिन्यू प्रॉपरली। यू विल गेट माय वीडियो इन एवरी वीक। वी ऑलरेडी फिनिश्ड कोडिलिटी फॉर प्रोग्रामर्स प्रॉब्लम लेसन 1 to 7। Today we will start 8. The lesson number is leader. We will find out the leader from through this problem we will find out how we can get leader from the array. And this is the documentation to know something about leaders. There is some theoretical explanation and also with code. We can read it and we can try to understand it and how we can do it properly. I hope you can read it by yourself. You will understand. If you will not understand, please write me in comment. I will try to explain. Now let's start to solve the problem dominator. For more visibility, I made it zoom. Now let's start. I should make it light, then you will understand problem statement. Let's start to read problem statement. As always, we are using Java programming language to solve the dominator problems. Let's start what we have to solve. An array A consists of n integers is given. The dominator of array A is the value that occurs in more than half of the elements of A. That means we have array A. Inside this array, we will have some integer value, and we should check those integer value is more than half or not. For example, you see array A, 0 index is 3, index number 1 is 4, index number 2 is 3, index number 3 is 2, index number 4 is 3, and like so on. And now our goal is to find out in which index the value is same. There are total 8 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That means total 8 elements. We should find out this value is more than half or not. This is our target. And the dominator of A is 3 because it occurs in 5 times out of 8 elements. That means we have 8 elements. And 3 is occurs 5 times. And namely in these indices, index number 0, 2, 4, 6, 7, those 5. 0, 2, 4, 6 and 7, and 5 is more than half of 8. Write a function, class solution, public int solution. And if it's not, the function should return minus 1. And this is the problem statement, and what it will give output. The function may return, it can return 0, 2, 4, 6 or 7, any one index number, because those index number the value is same. That's why if we will get more than half, then it will provide us the only index number, one index number. Now let's start how we can solve it. I already did it. And I think the code is little bit bigger. If I will write code with you, then it will take more time. Maybe you will be distracted. That's why I should take this code from my solution and I will explain step by step. It will be more helpful for you. This is the code. Now let's start line by line. Then if we'll it will more helpful. At first I am checking condition if error length is 0 or not. If it's 0, then return on, because we don't need to check. This is the primary condition. After that I define two variable, one is count, another one is int element. I don't need to use static because I am not using main method, so it's okay. First one I took count, and initially I define it 0, and second one its element. I will check how many elements, and it should be, initially I define its index number 0. Later I use for each loop, and inside the for each loop at first I call variable in variable, because our value is our element, our value is int, and this is the variable name I, and this is the array values. I initialize array values inside the I. Now later I am checking condition. I am checking if I equal to elements, that means index number 0, whatever the index number is 3. In 0, then the value is 3. In index number 0, the value is 3. Then count plus plus. Else, if it not, then I have to go else statement. If count equal to 0, if it's 0, then I should increase it. That's why I use plus plus. When I am checking condition, I am using two equal sign. You should remember it. One equal sign means assigning value. Two equal sign means we are checking condition. After that, if count is increasing, then I should define now element equal to I. That means I will be increased step by step. Later, what I did, if the condition is false, then it will go directly here. Count decrease. Minus minus means decrease. This is our control flow statement for checking our array values. Now I define another two variables, and one is count. I already use count one time, that's why I wrote here in a short form. Later I took another variable, its index, and those variable types is int, and primarily I initialize minus 1. The array value should be last one, that's why I define minus 1. Then I use for loop. Inside the for loop I define array length, and later I am checking the inside array values if ai equal to elements. Ai means this value. I already assigned array length value inside the I, so at first I am checking a if ai, that means array I. At first we start to count index number 0, that's why it should be index number 0, value is 3. If I equal to element, that means my targeted element, then count plus plus, that means it will start count how many times the element is occur inside the array. And third line we are checking, if it's true, then index equal to I. It will give us the index number. And later I am checking, this is the most important condition, because our main condition is, I am showing what is our main condition. The array A consists of the denominator has below more than half. This is our main target. And all this code will help to calculate it properly, and this code, this conditional statement will help to find out how many times it occurs, how many times this value is occur. So I am checking if count is greater than a length divided by 2, because it should be more than half. That's why if it's true, if this value is, this condition is true, then it should return index number. If it's false, then return minus 1 according to the problem statement, return minus 1. I hope everyone understand, because I tried to explain all the logical things and every single line then you can understand easily. And if you have any question or any queries, you can ask me. You can ask your queries in comment box and I will try to answer all of the comments. And you can follow my channel and you can subscribe my channel. I will provide all problem solution from Codality for programmer, and later I will switch maybe HackerRank or other problems, and I will solve it. We will solve it together, and I hope everyone understand. Now let's go for test. Is it working or not? That means it fulfill the condition, like a example test. According to their problem statement, we did it. That's why it's testing. It's okay. Now let's go for submission and we will check if it's fulfill all the requirements or not. If it will fulfills all the requirements, then we will get 100% score. It's evaluating. That's fine. It's fulfilled all the condition. That's why we received 100%. And this is our code. I hope everyone understand properly. And if you can concern, if you will face any problem, just let me know. If you are not clear about concept, please let me know. I am always free to help. And according to performance test, we fulfill all the condition. Correctness, it's 100%. Example test, it's also 100%. So thank you very much. See you in my next video. Till then, take care. Bye bye. See you. Bye.